all welcome, all my vault dwellers, and today me, are going to be experiencing a life in the Commonwealth of Fallout. Yes, I did not mean to take that, do not need a typewriter, but whatever. Take the ashtray though, dirty ashtray. So, I've been doing a lot of stuff, a lot of missions, should have recorded this quite a while ago. I did do like a few recordings of this. I was talking about life of a high schooler, but I did not record a single thing that happened here, and I already did the whole main mission, you know, I found my son and everything. I would not be talking about that, because spoilers. So I'm just trying to survive and do some other missions that I'm discovering. And so far, I'm not having such a good time because, well, I have no idea what to do now. Ever since I destroyed something, I will not be saying what I destroyed, but ever since I destroyed something, I have no other missions to do, just continuous missions. I just keep going back and forth, back and forth, and it's just the same thing. Oh, Slotsoffun, go do this, and then I do it, go back, thank you, go do it again, do it, thank you, go do it again, do it, thank you, go do it again, and it's just over and over and over again. What the? Whoa, okay. What the hell? Well, that scared me. I need to take some rat away. What the hell was that? Okay, that scared me a bit. I'm not gonna lie, that terrified me. So here's what happened. After I destroyed something that's very important to the story, after I did that, I no longer can receive any more missions for the Railroad or the Brotherhood. If you know the person Glory, who is a synth, the people in the Railroad keep saying that she's dead. Oh, so sorry, Glory has died. Oh, it's so hard to do missions now that Glory's dead. But Glory is alive. So, what the heck? So, that confused me so much. Also, if you also know about Pam in the Railroad, she sends me on missions. She sends me on missions to go and destroy some Brotherhood patrols even afterwards, depending on how they're destroyed. And I would love to do those. However, some of the Brotherhood people have been destroyed. That's really weird. Look it. What does it say? Eliminate the Brotherhood patrol. Show summary. Even with the Prindlewin destroyed, the Brotherhood stragglers are a threat to the Railroad. Pam has spotted a surviving patrol. It is my job to deal with them. Okay, that's all good. Unfortunately, though, what is this? The Prindlewin? Huh? What? I'm able to still go there. What the heck? It's been glitching out some time, and I have no other missions to do, just a lot of continuous ones. And I don't like it, because I want to go do some more story missions, so I'm just, right now, just walking around, trying to find anything I can find useful. And live my time, but I'm having no such luck, you know, so it's sucky, but that's what happens when you're in Fallout 4, and it's just my luck. I don't know if like it happened because I joined up with the Minutemen to go destroy something, to go do the mission, or is it because I turned down the mission to not stay a while in the place, the Institute. Oh, oops, my bad. Shouldn't have said that, but I said that. Who cares? So that's what happened. And look at these lovely trees. Oh, such beautiful economic trees. Lovely. Nothing like exploring a wasteland at night. This looks like a Slender Man type thing, except it's like an update where you have actually a gun. That'd be so crazy if there's a person called Slender Man. Oh, was this your chest? And a shovel? What the hell? Oh! Okay. God, he missed. Don't you dare sneak a blade like that again. Take your death hand. And your fuses and your plasma cartridge. Don't you dare do that. I don't care if you have boulders in your little garden thing. You little jerk. This is what happens, see? You can never go at night. Bad things happen in the Commonwealth at night. Maybe there would be like a lot more scary things that happen in Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas. I haven't ever played that in a while. I haven't played Fallout New Vegas at all. Play Fallout 3. Die, ghoul. Die, ghoul. Codsworth, I think everyone's dead. Ah, there's a ghoul behind me.
All quiet here. Stay tuned for Minutemen alerts.
Where the hell's a ghoul? Oh, ghoul. Yoo-hoo. That's my brother you're hearing, isn't he? Sounding lovely. Just peachy keen, isn't he? I hear gunshots. Oh, I hear lasers. There's a fight. Let's go see the fight. Don't that look magnificent? Okay, who's fighting? Ooh, Minutemen. Oh, she died. Boo-hoo-hoo. I really don't care about the Brotherhood of Steel. I know they mean good and all that. I just don't care about them. They would rather kill everything they see than talk about it. Oh, shoot! Oh, I thought that was a raider. You know, I would say I never get scared at all, and that is true, I don't. It's just, everyone gets startled. Well, I didn't really get startled. But you get scared when something jumps out at you. Okay? I don't get scared easily. I guess you could say I'm lying, but I really don't. It's just that startled me. Watch, I'll prove it. If something scary happens next, I won't get scared. No matter what happens, even if it's a legendary deathfall. Ooh, that sucks. They got killed by some feral ghouls. That's sad. Even I have to say, even though I don't like the Brotherhood of Steel, I feel sorry for them. Getting killed by that type of enemy. Yeah. I'm going the wrong way. Such a lovely church. Oh, there's a beacon. It's a radio tower. I need to go there. It's always so sad when you have to listen to those radio towers. I always cry. Hey, first one. That's perfect. Hello, Nick Swanson. Welcome to the Commonwealth, I must say. So you and me are in for quite a treat.
Nothing new to report.
Let's see. Ooh, there's some lovely little glowing lights. I would love to have a bus like this. You know, I remember this one bus I was in. It had seatbelts. I did not like that. I like buses when they don't have seatbelts. I know it's safety precautions, but still, I'm used to having buses with no seatbelts. What are you talking about, Cosmo? Was he? Oh, okay. Whatever. I guess he was fighting somebody. He didn't even notice me. I didn't even get any XP from it. What the heck? Oh, must I just say, Nick Swanson over here, go subscribe to his channel. I'm pretty sure he makes so much better content than I do. He make horrible content. I'm just a commentator. Yet, I am a commentator for the time being. Oh, you stupid monkey! I hate you, not creepy, you're just annoying. Die. I hear you. Oh, you missed. I feel so sorry, but like I said, go subscribe to his channel. He makes so much better content than I do, and he should be the next biggest YouTuber. I should be the second biggest YouTuber, because number two also good. When do you hear that every time? Let's unlock this guy.
You're tuned to Radio Freedom.
And, oh, you're awesome. I was about to say handsome. He didn't say handsome, he said awesome. My mistake. Okay, faces. Let's go to slave. No slave glass. Nothing. Houses. You know, screw this. I'm not gonna lock you. You're a bad person. Get out of here. Am I right, sir? Should I drink the water? I'm gonna drink the water. Thank you.
Other side's chained up.
That's some delicious water. Let's go upstairs. Can't go upstairs. Oh, great. Can't go up the freaking stairs. Open door. Look at mirror. Nothing I don't like report. That. You can't look keep yourself in the mirror. I mean, you may look ugly, but look at this beautiful face. Such a lovely looking face. And you can't look at yourself in the mirror. Let's see. Hold up. Bottle caps. Bottle. Oh, you. You know how bad that would be, though? Okay, picture this. You're a little kid sitting in school with no windows because it looks like this has been chalked out. But anyway, you're sitting in school. All of a sudden, boom. And you die in school. That would be terrible. The nukes. A nuclear bomb just fell and you're dead. Wow. Oh, my. That's a face. I never. What the hell? That's a face. I never noticed that. I'm astonished by a face. What the hell is it? Oh, this is nasty. Somebody got gum all over the teacher's desk. I hope it's gum. Mr. Davison's terminal. Welcome to Aruba complaint letter draft.
I'm sorry to ask, but where has the integrity of this school gone? Forcing all teachers and students to consume nothing but flavorless pink goo is inhumane and demoralizing. Sorry, had a cough. Back to where was I? Food is an avenue of socialism for our students' growing minds, and they are growing this muscles for the paste, if nothing else. I am sure you have noticed the growing rate of visits to the office of Mr. Haver. Also, I would also swear some everyone seems a little bit pinker after a week of eating this stuff. Please, I ask that we terminate this mistake of an experiment and find alternative funding opportunities for the school. Mr. Smith, English Department.
Okay, I heard about the food paste, and I heard that it makes you go crazy. It makes you go a little cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs, if you know what I mean. And they force the school to eat nothing but food paste? Are you kidding me? I mean, like, yeah, school food to me is disgusting. But eating, I would rather eat the school food I have than the freaking pink paste. Plus, it makes you turn pink. I mean, pink is a good shade of color, but not for me. I do not like pink. You will stay down, you maggots. You do not get up from there. Learn your manners. You too. I say back! Back, I say! You disgusting boogers. Why would you need a hairbrush, you feral ghoul? Ew, he's naked. That's a lovely drawing. If I would ever draw something like that in school, they would get me arrested. Well, not really arrested, but they'll send me to the principal's office. Oh, the poor janitor died too. Not the janitor. He was such a lovely person. Oh, there's a basement. Cool. Wait a second. This is like an auditorium. Nutshot. Oh, I missed. Take that. Yeah, I'm a hero. Oh, this is I thought there was some blood, but now I know it's pink paste, food paste. This is nasty. It's like that one scene from Wall-E where like all those chubby humans are in the spaceship and they're drinking the food. That's just nasty to me. Hey, baseball! I don't care. So they would shred up food and throw it in there. How much stuff do I can carry? I don't have that much stuff to carry. Cosworth, my old
man. I imagine this place is giving the old nostrils quite the wake-up call. Of course.
Trust me, you're lucky you're a robot. As for me, I have to deal with this smell. Please hold all of this, Cosworth. Thank you. You're such a lovely Mr. Handy. A box of industry cleaner. I must say, you know, Nick Swanson over there, he has been watching this for some time now, and any normal human being would run away from, no, well, not run away, they can't run away, would just click out of this video and not watch it ever again. But he is not a regular human being. He wants to watch this video. I don't know why, but I guess he just loves the content that I make, and plus I had to give out a shout out to him. I think he has more subscribers than me. I'm pretty sure. I think he has like 1,000. I only have 64, but that is a higher number than 63, so I'm happy.
Listening from a safe place. All quiet, which is how we like it. Stay safe out there.
Okay, I'm changing the radio channel. Diamond City. Oh, I hate this song. I'm the most hit hard of all people who live in my hometown. Whoop! I'm swinging up right now. And devil people never ever let you down. Should go on American Got Talent. You know what? I'm actually gonna tell another Life of a High Schooler story because, well, it's Tuesday and I have to upload. What the hell was that? I just glitched out for a second. Okay, so this one actually is from my grandma, and I just love my grandma. I really do. My dad's mom, and she's just so funny because her old age makes her forgetful and makes her do really, really dumb things, but it's funny and she laughs about it too, so it's just something I like.
It.
Baseball is awesome? Well, of course baseball is awesome. I just don't want to pick it up because I have no reason for me to pick it up, but baseball is awesome, Swanson. Okay, I must clear things up for a bit before I continue the video, or not the video, the story. I'm getting your comments way later, so yes. You're at a point where I've passed it, and then your comment will appear a different time. So once you get this, just keep that in mind, and try to predict something that's gonna happen. So let's make it fun. So that's what I was saying. Also, baseball is awesome. I'm gonna tell a story about baseball too. I'm gonna tell one about what happened to my grandma. Yes. Hold up. I'm doing a broadcasting. Cannot exit right away. Anyway. So this happened actually after I had a baseball game. I used to play baseball in the minor league. That little jerk. What the hell? Yeah, I used to play baseball when I was in the minor league, and I must say, I wasn't the best player, but I was a really good player. Well, I guess if I wasn't the best player, then I wouldn't have been able to get onto the all-star team, unless the coaches really liked me and liked my enthusiasm because I loved baseball so much. But whatever, we get back to the story, I'm getting off topic. So this is after my game when I was in the minor league. I think it was either minor or major league, I don't know, I can't remember. But after that whole thing, the game ended around 8:30-ish. It started at 5 and around 8:30, and it was a really hot day. It was going to be a really hot day, and it was... your comment made me think of the future. It was a hot day, and what happened was... it was a good game. We won by a point, so that's cool. But, after the game, I go to my grandma's house. My dad picks me up, and in the car is my mom and my brother, my little brother. So we go to my grandma's house, who lives close by a mountain. That has nothing to do. I just want to say she lives by a mountain. So when we go over there, I have my uniform all on still, and I take an extra pair of clothes because I was told that we were going to my grandma's house. So when we got there, I went to the restroom, I changed into my normal clothes, I took all my stuff off, everything off, and I just put my stuff on the chair. So that happened, and hold up. When that happened, I just dumped all my clothes in the chair, and there was food served, so I was able to get some food. So I go into the kitchen, I get my bowl of food and everything, and I'm just, you know, enjoying the meal. Because my grandma can cook some real good food. She's Mexican, I love it. Mexican food is amazing. All food's amazing, but I like Mexican food. It's like top 3 favorite foods to eat. Anyway, my dad gets an idea where he wants to pull a prank on my grandma, because he always does. But this one's, to me, is sad, funny, and disgusting. So, if you know about sports, for guys, I don't know about girls, but for guys, you wear a cup to protect your little thing, or big thing for me. Anyway, my dad gets my cup, and I've used it, okay? It's been used. So he gets it, and he goes over to my grandma, and her being old, she's not rather really good at, you know, having good lungs to support her, her breathing and all that. So my dad goes to her and says, "Hey, Mom, what the hell is that? Oh, that's a queen. Sweet, I'm gonna go kill it." Anyway, he goes over there and he says, "Mom, this?" And she's like, "Yeah, what is that?" And he says, "Well, this is a new breathing machine. If you put it on your nose and you breathe in, you'll be able to smell so much better. It'll actually help your lungs." So she takes it, not thinking, and says, "Oh, really? Let me try. So she takes it, sticks it right with her nose. The whole entire cup is just covering her mouth and her nose. And she goes, like that. And she's like, "Oh, yeah, yeah. I can smell that. I can smell perfectly good." So she makes another big whiff. She goes, like that. So I get done. At that point, I get done eating my food. I walk out. And I just see my grandma sniffing my cup. I have no idea what's happening. So I say, "Grandma, what are you doing? Why are you smelling that? That's my cup. I just used that." And then she instantly knew what she was smelling. And she just, oh, she was just, this was so mad at my dad. Oh, that rhymes. But I felt so bad for her, but I was laughing too. It was funny. It's just one of those things that's disgusting, but you have to laugh because it's not being done to you. And at the time, my grandma hated that. But now, if you ever mention that to her, she'll laugh about it. So I think she'll still hate it. There's also this one time I was playing baseball where it was my last game, and it was my last game ever to play baseball because I wasn't able to afford to go on another game. I don't play high school baseball because, one, I don't have the equipment, but I would have to be able to, get equipment from the school. It's just I don't have no more skill in baseball. All my skill in it is gone, so I can't play that well anymore. And it affects me so much, so I just haven't played baseball in a while. Would I ever play it again? I would love to. But I can't. Hold up! Alex! We're going on another adventure. We need to go to school. Go put that trash out.
My head.
Mom is getting mad. And I cannot pause this game. Well, I can. But I cannot pause the broadcast. Get the trash. Hurry up. Well, that's just mean. Where's my gun? There you are. No, not that one. That one. There we go. Okay. Gotcha. That's one more. Gotcha. Okay, I am going to be doing something for the time being. Ooh, I can build stuff here. That's nice. I'm going to pause the game right about here, and I'll be right back. It'll just only take me a few minutes. So go enjoy. Whoever's watching this, Nick Swanson, that's the only person I see right now. But whoever else is watching this, go enjoy something else for the time being, and I'll come back and unbox about a minute. 1 minute. Let's go. Time it. And if I'm wrong, then let me know in the comments. Be right back. I'm back. Did I make it on time? I don't know. I'm tired. I had to run. I'm out of shape. I need to go run. This is bad. Luckily, I don't have PE next year, but still, I should go run. Okay, let's continue our journey to that place. Where'd it go? That place. 1 minute, 38 seconds. Crap. Well, I was close. It took a minute, not 2 minutes, but been better if I would have been back here in a minute. Anyway. Okay, I'm better. Anyway, so in baseball, I was able to... What the hell? Why am I... Oh, shoot. No, I hate this place. Okay. Anyway. Are they here? They're here, aren't they? They are here. Let's go on a killing spree. Anyway. So, during baseball, it was my last game. And, the very last game, like I said. And... It was the last game for the coach, and we decided to go out with a bang. I mean, we've been winning a lot of games in the past, but we wanted to win this one definitely for our coach. It was just something we wanted to do. Like, not like just win a little bit. No, we wanted to destroy the other team. So we start, you know, doing what all teams do. Go out there and you're losing. Just like any normal team. We were losing. Sucks though, but that's what happened. So towards the second half, once the team scored about 3 points, we had zero. The sixth inning happened, and that's when we began to get picked up. So during the sixth inning, it was three us, six or five them. So I went up to bat. I'm the third batter. I always like being the third batter. That's my favorite number, being third batter. Anyway, I go up to bat, and they got a new pitcher. Okay, this guy was subbed in during the fourth inning, so he was striking out a good number of my teammates. So I go up to bat, and I'm thinking like, okay, I gotta do this, I have to win, I have to do this, all this. I go up to bat, first pitch, strike. Second pitch, ball. Third pitch, I connect. I just hit that ball so hard. The thing goes flying, it goes right by the fence gate. It could have been a home run, but it wasn't. So, I wasn't mad that I didn't get a home run. I ran, and this was the fastest I ever ran in my history of baseball as a little kid. So I'm running as much as I can. I need to buy more stim packs. And I pass first base like nothing. I pass second base like nothing. I pass third base like nothing. I go home. And the people, even the pitcher, was like, did that just really happen? And I felt so, so happy. All my team was like, yeah, like you did it and all that stuff. So that made our team score two more points, two more runs. And it was amazing. We caught up, we tied it, and it was tied for about, what's it called? Up until the eighth inning, in which they scored again. I don't know how, I can't remember, I think they did. I'm just missing this guy, I can't even hit him. Cosworth, attack him! Anyway, so I go up to bat, miss the eighth inning. When they saw me, they still had the same pitcher for the inning. But when I went up to bat, that's when they switched out their pitcher, and they brought out this really big, huge guy, like huge, okay, like fat, not that fat, but he was fat, or should I say chunky, since that's kind of means calling him a bastard. But it comes out, I died. I just died. This is why I hate the place, because I died. Anyway, so he comes out, and this guy is known for throwing tremendously fast fastballs. And we played with the team again before when we lost, which is why we also wanted to go out with a bang with this team again. And we've seen that how the pitcher pitches, so we know how fast it can go. So he goes. Very first pitch. Instant hit. I connected so well. And that thing went far again, and it hit the wall, and I just loved that. The pitcher couldn't believe it. I got another inside the park and run. I ran all the way to home base, and I was just so happy. It was the best thing ever that happened to me in baseball, besides being an All-Stars. Oh, I gotta kill the Marler. Are you kidding me? Damn. Die, goon! Wait, let me switch my weapon. What? What? Are you? That's for you! Let me bathe in the glory that I just killed your freaking leader with one shot of this weapon! Why can't you just let me enjoy my peace? You're such a Marler. Kill you! Well, that was crazy though. I didn't even know I could do that with this weapon. Just one hit, bam! Please don't make me die. Please don't make me die. Please. Okay. Turn of wham! Wham! Wait. One, two. Oh, I didn't kill it. Okay, try again. Oh, there it goes. We did it. Ooh, Ghoul Slayer pistol. That is nice. Very nice. My lurk meat. My lurk meat. I'm getting hungry now. Not for my lurk meat. That's disgusting. I'm getting hungry for something. My favorite food, I would just say, is Italian food. I just love Italian food. Not pizza. I like eating pizza, but not as much. I like pasta instead. Like tortellini, macaroni, fettuccine with some Alfredo sauce and chicken. Like a lot of good pasta. I just love pasta. I'm a pasta guy. I'm going the wrong way. Where am I? I'm supposed to go that way. Where the hell am I going? I don't know. Dot 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 dot. 33 minutes already. This is something right now. Okay. Well, I see nothing but fog and trees. This is nothing. No person should watch this, because this is boring right now. Action has to happen. This is boring. Completely boring. Unless I tell stories. Okay, I'm gonna tell a ghost story. I remember this one ghost story. This one scared me. I can't remember it from word, but it just scared me when I was a little kid. Ooh! Ghouls and Marlers, I want to see who wins. Okay, before I tell the story, I'm going to watch this fight. You jerk, you're supposed to fight him, not me. Well, now you're disqualified. Get out of here. I want to see this fight. Oh, they're dying. Hello, bud. Oh, Cosmos, you didn't have to really interfere. Shame on you. I wanted to see the fight. Oh, the Marlock won. Never mind. What's a silk beam? No, is that a... That's a minute, man. I let them die. I let them die. And there was a Brotherhood of Steel print thing. Minuteman! No! I have to take my job as a Minuteman General very seriously. Please tell me that there's a power armor. There's a power armor. I let my Minuteman people die. I thought they could defend it themselves, but I guess I was wrong. I thought they could defend it. Why is everyone still alive? X01. Ooh. Ta-da! I did it! Ooh, this is a nice one. I have no headlight. That sucks. Don't that look spectacular? Like, so machoed out. Crap, I can't believe I freaking looked at Miniman die. I feel so terrible now. But I got really cool power armor, so I guess it's good. Anyway, back to the story. So, we'll be now dwelling into the creepy story of Top Top Scratch Scratch. Back then, there was an old school, like a very old school, back in the... Why can't I go that way? I can't? Oh, I can't. Huh. I can't go that way. What do you know? Anyway, I can't go that way. Oh, why can't I go that way? Am I gonna fall? Whatever. Anyway, back then there was this really old schoolhouse. Back in like the 1950s or so. Oh my gosh. And they were having a Halloween party. That was pretty cool. Very cool. So the teacher was throwing the whole party, everything. The students were enjoying it and everything and all that. And what happened was, they were just enjoying a party, you know, as kids would love to enjoy parties. Wouldn't you love to enjoy a party? I know I would. But when they turned on the radio to like play on some music, it was like this, a normal little party, music playing and all that. However, when they turned it on, the radio broadcast switched to a newscast saying that there was an escaped serial killer on the loose and that people should be aware to lock their doors and close their windows, for they have no idea where this serial killer is, and advise people to, it's a fat bamboo. They advise people to not go out during this whole thing, wait till the police are ready and can find this person. So, that's what they did. The schoolhouse then locked up the windows, they locked the doors, they locked everything up, and they waited until the announcements were done. So, as fate would have it, this little girl decided that she wanted to go outside to use the restroom. The teacher insisted on not letting the little girl out because, well, there was a serial killer. But this is a scary story, and you know logic doesn't apply here. So after a constant arguing, the girl happened to go to the restroom so bad, the teacher complied and told her, okay, but to make sure that we know it's you, come back and I want you to do on the door, tap, tap, scratch, scratch. That is your code to get back inside, and that is to let us know that... Let us know that that is so. Little girl said okay, and it is. Went to go outside to do their business. Minutes passed by, and there hasn't been no sign of the little girl. People start to get worried and everything. So, at the speak of the devil, everyone heard tap, tap, scratch, scratch. However, some of the people there, the students, felt something was off. It took her this long to see the restroom. That seems a bit weird. And now all of a sudden, she's come back. They did not want to go check the windows to make sure it was her because they were in fear that it might have been the killer. However, the teacher insisted that was her before no one else. How would the serial killer know about the code? So she went to go open the door. And as she did, she saw the man holding a bloody knife and the little girl's head, each in one hand, smiling a sadistic smile. This frightened the teacher so much that she jumped out. She jumped out of the window, crashed, and she was cut up and everything, but she ran. What happens to the kids? Well, I'm sorry to say, they didn't make it. They were cut up just like that little girl, their heads chopped off and everything.
The cops were eventually to find the serial killer, but not before when they all the little kids were dead. The teacher went insane and couldn't believe it, and she died in her insanity. The killer died due to being put to death in the electric chair.
That was Billy Ward
and
the
people
Domino.
Say that if you're able to go to this place, it's still there. If you can. And if you go there, to the area that the school was once at, you can hear the little girl's screams of agony and pain that was being created from her. And also, you can also hear the screams of the other kids that were being tortured and slaughtered by that one man. But that's just the story, so I don't think none of that's just true. I mean, there are serial killers and all that, but I don't think that story is true. And if it was true, there would be like a lot of police reports about it. Unless the police doesn't want us to know about that.
But you'd be wrong. It's empty. Abandoned.
Wasn't that such a fun story? Now, you know, Sesame Street won't be talking about that anymore.
But given how creepy that place was,
you know, give Swanson over here a medal. Give him a medal. He has been with us for 41 minutes, about to be 42 minutes. Give this guy a Nobel Peace Prize, you know? I don't think, I don't know how many else people are watching, but I just only see him. It'd be nice to let him know if someone else is watching this, unless they don't really want to, unless they're shy. If you're shy, then it's okay. I understand. You have to eat quick? Oh, I understand. Go on and eat. Let's see. Cosmos, what are you talking about?
What the?
Cosmos, what are you talking about? Whoa! He teleported! Hey! Hello! Worry, 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 passing me by. Lock the dock, the dock. Worry, 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 passing me by. I go but worrying right along. Yeah. My name's not Joe, my name is Harry. Worry, 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 woe is me. There you are. Oh, okay. So you'll still be here, that's good. Well, maybe you can eat in the watch. You can't even watch, I understand. Because not nice to take your thing, your device, to the dinner. That is not good. Worry, 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 woe is me.
Yes.
I'm a fool about love. Da 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 da. I have such a natural, beautiful voice. Maybe I should sing on this channel, you know, like just one day. What's up, guys? Love to find. I'll be singing you a song. Yeah, right. No one want to hear me sing. Nobody. Plus, how I make a fool out of myself. It's not my thing. I am so sorry. Don't look at me like that. Nasty. La 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 la. Hey, look at chickens out. Watch, watch, watch. Whee! I love doing that. Makes me feel like I'm Superman. I cannot find any place that I haven't been to. Ba-ba-da-da-da-da-da-da. What the heck? Watch out! Watch out! Did it! I like the song because it makes fun of men, and I'm a man, so ironic. Sing it, girl! Uh-huh. Da 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 da, it's a man. I know those things are itchy. I have to shave today. I shaved on one half of my side of the face, like not even the full thing, but I shaved like a little bit. Cause I had to go do some chores and I was in a rush, so I just shaved a little bit.
and I should save. Don't let that fool ya! If you don't know what this song means, basically it's saying this girl, if you're a girl, if you ever find a man who acts like a man, I should say, how the stereotype of a man is, if he acts like that, leave it. Don't you dare get married to him. However, if there's a man that treats you nice and respect like a human being, like a woman should be treated, then by all means, marry the guy. And hopefully he never changes. But as years go by, we humans tend to change our mindset about certain things. No one stays the same because something happens to you which affects you. Take me, for example. I was bullied as a kid. Before I used to live in this such a nice neighborhood and everything, and I moved away for reasons I shall not say because they're personal. But I moved away, went to a school that I just hated so much, and I was only there for 4 months, and I was bullied. Not only by the students, but also by the teachers and the staff that was working there too. They did not help me. I remember this one kid choked me, like he picked me up by the shirt or like the neck and was choking me a bit, and I forgot what he said, but he said something, and I looked at him, and he just looked at me with a smug look on his face. So I went, the natural thing that I was told to do was go tell the teacher, but I didn't really do that the very first day. I told my parents, which then we were told to go to the teacher, and they didn't do nothing. The whole staff didn't do nothing. Granted, though, I couldn't see the kid's face that well because I wasn't paying attention to his face. I was just shocked that happened to me, because that was the very first time something like that ever happened to me, where some guy picked me up and was choking me and just doing that. So I was thrown off guard. Oh, an iBot. So I went to go, I told the staff and everything. They couldn't do that much, but they said that they would try to find this person and get him suspended and all that. So I'm like, oh, okay. I had a lot more runs. The very first 2 weeks after I was there, my report card came, and I had nothing but Fs. All my grades now were Fs. And because the teachers that were doing it, they were using grades that they were... they put in grades that they already put in a while back. Meaning, in the very beginning of the second semester, they had all the assignments into my grades. And since I just barely came into the school, I wasn't able to do it, the assignments, any of them. So what the heck? I was only able to do the ones where I was actually at the school and able to do. But the rest, nope, because I wasn't there. So we had a whole little discussion about that. And then eventually we were able to get it working again and all that. But for the time being, that actually got me mad, where the teacher was cutting stuff that I wasn't able even to do because it wasn't at the school. And not only that, but there were this one kid, I got pantsed at the school. I'm pretty sure there's like a lot more worse stories. Like, oh, I got pantsed, big deal, But to me, you have to understand where it was my very first time getting bullied. And I was in a place, a society, where everything was nice. There was no reason to get bullied. You were just in this beautiful society where you never got bullied. And going to a school where I was bullied really just, really affected me. So there are a bunch of people that have worse experience than I do, where they tend to have suicidal thoughts and all that. I never had any suicidal thoughts. I never will. But I was just, shocked. And I just learned to grow a hatred for that school. I just couldn't, I just didn't like being there at all. I had some good friends, but those friends really weren't the same ones like I had at the other school. And it was just sad. It was really sad. The guy pants me, and I was embarrassed, okay? If you do something to me now, or I could just do almost anything, and I wouldn't get embarrassed that much. But I
still get embarrassed from time and again, but when that happened to me, like if I were to get passed in school, I wouldn't care. I wouldn't, it wouldn't really affect me that much. But, I gotta freaking, I gotta go somewhere right now. Let me go to...
Now folks, I'm sure you've all seen or heard about the latest issue of public
anyway,
occurrences.
So like if you were to pass me right now in school, I wouldn't be embarrassed, like... Yeah, I would laugh too, actually. I wouldn't be embarrassed. But at that time, when I very first got pants for my first time, it affected me so much. And I was truly, truly embarrassed. Luckily, though, it was only my boxers showing. He didn't pull both my shorts and my boxers down. We were in PE at the time. And thankfully, that didn't happen because that would have been super embarrassing. I don't know what I would have done if that happened. But that kid... The teachers weren't out there, so pretty much you can do anything you want to, and it sucks. It really does. But I was able to not get truly embarrassed. I told the teacher he got suspended for only 2 days for pantsing some kid, which I guess, if you think it's a good punishment, only 2 days of suspension for pantsing some kid, then yeah. But for me, I wanted him to get expelled.
The mayor himself insists that the fears raised in the article.
But, that didn't happen. For. Anyway, so we go.
But between and, you and me, listeners, I'm gonna keep my eyes open.
Aw, Cosmos idolizes me. Thank you, Cosmos. So he gets suspended and all that, and he comes back 2 days after, and he just has this smug look on his face, and he's just like, his friends were like, "Oh, so what happened when you were suspended?" And the guys are like, "Oh, well, the very first day I just went home and relaxed and everything, and the second day I went to Castle Park."
Hey.
And as he was saying that, he was looking at me, so I'm just thinking like, "Are you kidding me? Like." Really, that's a punishment? He gets to go out of school, a school that I hate, and is able to just go any place, you know? So that got me so mad, but hey, you know, it happens. There was nothing I could do. There was like a lot more stories too that I truly, truly hate. But overall, it doesn't really affect me that much. I mean, it does, but now I'm no longer there at that school, and I'm no longer there at that area, so I'm just happy I'm gone. But at that time, I hated that school so much. Let me know in the comments of this if you've ever been bullied too. Let me know your experience, because I'm pretty sure mine... My experience isn't as bad as what you've probably been through, but for me, that was suckish. And the staff, like I said, they wouldn't help. I even went to the principal. He wasn't even help either. So there was no one I could turn to except my parents. And my parents were like, okay, we're going to be moving very soon. Just get by these last 4 months of school and you'll be able to go back to your old school. Whoa, that looks nice. So I was able to get by. I left the school, and I didn't look back. Once I left the school, that was it. I did not want to ever go back there again. And every time I passed by it, I just, like, picture myself blowing up the school. Not blowing up people inside, because I don't want to kill nobody, but just blowing up the school. Or not even the school, just changing how it is, how the way it's setting itself up, because it's not, to me at the time, it didn't feel like a school. It felt as a punishment that these kids would have to go to there and would have to get picked, because it was either you were unknown to the people, you either the ones that were being bullied, or you were the ones that were doing the bulliness. And that's not a real word, but you were the bully. So it got me mad. It really did. There's like a lot of other experience I had with being bullied, but that school changed me. And it now, if you ever can, like, it takes a lot to get me mad, but when you do, I will now, if you punch me, I will punch you back. If you throw the first punch, I will swing back.
Whether I win or lose doesn't matter, but I will fight now. And it was because of that school and also other schools that I will not be talking about, because that's my personal life and I really don't want to be discussing that, even though I discuss other funny things that happen to me. Just some stuff I limit and I don't talk about at all because it's my business, and leave it at that. So that's what happened to me. And I just picture what would happen if I wouldn't... What the... I just think, what would have happened if I never went to that school at all? If I lived in my community, my old home, and I never would have moved. I just want to think, what would I become? I like to think that I might become like a... where I wouldn't, you know, be into violence and all that. I'm really not into violence, but... it's because of that school where now I would fight. What the hell is that? Oh, that's a rock. So, that's what happened to me. Hopefully, violence, it's never an issue at all. But there are some times when you have to defend yourself because, well, there's no other option. And that's... are you kidding me? Again, with this whole weather. I hate this. I gotta teleport somewhere. Let me go to... I don't know where to go. Let's go to the witchcraft. That's always a scary location to see. So, yeah. That's what happened. And I do not like it. If I had the power to go back in time and stop me from moving, I would love to. Where do I live? I live in my house. I don't like to share information about where I live and all that. If I'm ever able to get over a certain amount of subscribers that I have in mind, not 1 million, because that's common where people show their face and their address and all that. Well, not really their address, but their state where they live. When they hit like a million subscribers and all that. And for me, I have a number where I would love to reveal my face, to reveal who I am. But for that time, it's going to take a while, maybe, unless I just instantly become famous overnight, which probably won't even happen. But that's what's going to happen. That's what I want to do. So everything will be revealed in due time if I grow to become famous, which I don't know I will. Oh, I'm so strong. This place is spooky. The state I live, if you go with geography, I'll give you a puzzle. It's right next to Nevada and by an ocean. Are you kidding me? This weather loves following me, okay? It's right next to Nevada. Underneath, I would say Oregon, yeah. So, you know your states, then that's where I live. That's all I'm saying. I will not give away what city I live in that state, because that is going too far. Oh, hey, new places to explore. I haven't been here at all. Let's go. Sandy Cove's coastal home. Discover Salem. Let's go. A bongo bongo bongo, I don't wanna be the Congo. No 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 no. Banga banga bonga bon, happening in the front of the twos. I refuse to go. This song goes out to the Nick Swanson. I don't sir, want to sit. Never mind. Here. No song here.
Welcome to Sandy Cove's convalescent home. How may I help you?
I would like to check in.
I'm checking in. My family filled out the paperwork earlier.
Hey.
Welcome. We'll put you in Gladys's old room. Take the back stair and it's the first door on your left. Have a nice day.
Okay, what you are about to look, it's possibly going to disturb you. It is very sad. So, let's go. And if this affects you, I'm sorry. Okay? I'm sorry. This may disturb you, and it possibly will. And if you don't get what's happening, I will tell you. So, for right now, radio off. And let's go take a look. Yeah? Oh, come on. Okay, I'll have to go be right back. I'll pause right here. Oh crap, there's a synth. Why are there so many synths? Don't see me fire in this thing. I shall be right back, so when I come back, I will tell if you haven't already figured out what this place is about. So, 1 minute top. Well, a minute 38 tops. Here we go. Okay, so I'm back. And if you didn't figure out, this is Sandy Place. I don't really know the name. But when the bombs fell, everyone in here, all the elderly people, died. This is a place for the elderly. And they died. And what was very disturbing is that these Mr. Handys still treat them as patients. And it's real sad. But that's what happens. What other games do I have and what am I playing on? I have a lot of other games, not just this one. I have Battlefield 4, Battlefront, Rayman Legends. Rayman Legends. Four Soldiers War Chest. Two Lego games, Lego Marvel Super Heroes and Lego Hobbit. There it goes.
That's it.
I also have Shadow of Mordor, Fallout 4, obviously, Elder Scrolls Online, and Knack. Yep, that's all I have. So this place is actually pretty sad. And do I have a Snapchat? I do have a Snapchat. It's just I cannot use it on my device, on my tablet, because it just doesn't work anymore. I don't know why. It just doesn't. So it sucks. But it still works. I just can't use it. I don't know if you can. You'll be able to add me. It's just lots of fun. I just can't use it. So pretty much pointless for you to even add me in the first place.
Only opens with a key.
But oh snap! Oh, these.
Don't have the key. No way to pick this. Would need the key.
Damn it. Anyway. I only have that. Instagram, I do not. Should I get it? Yes, but I can't. Doesn't work for my device anyway. I don't have no phone. I have no Wave or anything like that. Just a PS4, PS3, this, TVs, tablet that doesn't support those apps. Yeah. Isn't that nice? I have no idea what else to say, and I usually just go rambling on about random things, but for some reason I have nothing else to say. Maybe there'll be a big fight here somewhere. Oh, what I know. Huh. I predicted the fight. Bonnie's turn. It's Bonnie. Hey, Bonnie. I love you. You love me. Trust me, I've been trying so much. It just says that it requires Google Play services, which I download that. And then when I do that, it goes to the home page where I press the login button. And it doesn't allow me to do my device. It doesn't allow me to, sign in. Like, I press the login button, I log in to everything, and it just keeps loading forever. And I tried to make a new account, and it's the same thing. I tried so many times. So I just have to wait. What the hell is happening, dude? I'm just hearing this one guy screaming like, "Wah, yeah, right on!" It's freaking me out. Let's go find this guy. Is he up? Where is he? I want to beat this guy. I know, it's really weird how that happens. And I would love to get Snapchat back again. And Instagram. I would love to get Instagram too. But it's just something I just need a phone or something. You know, something that will be able to support it. Oh, a mini nuke. Where is this guy? I want to find him. He sounds insane, which is why I want to find him. Maybe I'm hallucinating. Maybe that water that I drank is making me go crazy. Uh-oh, I'm a crazy man now with a gun.
It's gonna take a lot more than some big fish to scare me.
Oh, shoot. I know, I need to get a dog. And so far where I'm at, no one is hiring. And those people who are hiring are people who already, who you must need a, the people who are hiring when you need to get a job are ones that either have a college, not college degree, high school diploma, or some sort of college level thing. And I'm just gonna barely be a senior. So, yeah. Where's the other Mire Lurk? Oh, fishy! Fishy! Die, you fat crab! Good. Yes! I did it!
Are you crazy? Get out of the street before any more of them catch wind of ya! Look, I'll open the gate, and you get in here quick! I'm gonna let you in the bunker! Don't make me regret this!
Get in here, Codsworth! Alright, fine. Oh, he's coming up. Come on, come on, get in, get in. Get over here!
Hey, over here.
No, not there, here!
Hey, yes, move,
sir.
Here.
Right away, sir.
Oh my god. Forget you then. Okay, Barney. Am I really in my cool outfit? Yes, I am. Barney. Oh wait, he's in a bunker. He's not down here. Basement. Da 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 da. Bonnie. There you are.
Hey.
Son, did someone drop you on your head as a baby, or did you have to work to get this stuff?
I had to clean up this mess.
I could have handled myself.
Oh, I saw how you handle yourself, froze on the spot like a deer in headlights. If it weren't for me, you would have been cut up like a paper doll. Luckily, I've got Reba here to help me crack those crabs wide open. Isn't that right, girl?
I'm sorry if I caused any trouble.
Listen, don't let an old codger like me scare you. I'm old and I'm cranky and I haven't had a guest in months. Barney Rook, commander of the Salem Volunteer Militia, at your service. I'm also the quartermaster, sergeant-at-arms, and scribes for all official meetings. This here is Reba, but you two already met when she saved your life.
Thank you, Reba. And thank you, Barney.
No thanks needed, sir. The Salem Volunteer Militia is at the service of the people of the Commonwealth. Duty is its own reward. Reba says you're welcome.
His mustache
now,
is
I'd
weird.
Love to sit here gabbing all day like a couple of housewives. But we've got some work to do. And by we, I most definitely mean you. Before you showed up, the Mire Lurks had been mostly quiet. And those that were a problem were quickly dispatched by my turret defense system. Since things had been quiet lately, I took the turrets offline to conserve ammunition. Obviously, they need to be reactivated. And that's your mission, soldier. I'm going to continue to hold down the home front while you go reactivate the turrets.
Sounds good.
Of course it sounds good. I'm a tactical genius. Smartest man in town, as a matter of fact. The turrets should be easy enough to find. They're up high in strategic locations around town. Just be careful. All your noise probably woke up more crabbies and other Mire Lurks. The town could be crawling with them by now.
Great. Oh, fantastic. Okay, my day in the real world is going fine. I love it. But my day in Fallout? Oh, now I gotta go.
Excellent.
Freaking have to go crabby.
Taking the brain out for a storm.
I have to go kill more crabs. Gotta go kill more crabs. Why, thank you. That's a nice little compliment. I adore it. To think that this guy has been with me for the past hour and 16 minutes and 36 seconds is truly amazing. Now there's two people. Now there's one person. It went to, from two to one. But who cares? If people want to watch it, that's good. If they don't want to watch it, I understand. Bad content. That's a big... Oh, not a glowing one. Okay, I had enough with you. I am running out of ammo. Well, not really, but I'm technically running out of ammo. Why not? Making go gooey. Gooey. Come on. Fight me, crab. Come on then. That's what you get. Give me a bottle cap. Okay, I'll go up there. Let's see, I'm gonna switch to my... There we go. No, 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 no. This is what I want. Are you kidding me? Oh, I threw a frisbee at him. Alright, let's just get up here right now and turn on the turrets because I can't stand these Mar alerts. What is that? Is that a gun? That's not a gun, that's an ID block. Ha, stupid, you can't jump up here now. You can't come up here because I can only can't. I have legs, you don't. We have fiddlers. Enter password. Activate turret. Oh, that's. There's a bunch of turrets. I thought there was only one turret. Only one terminal you had to activate. Oh, I was misled. How about these turrets? Uh-oh. What was that? Car. Okay. I'm happy. Don't mind me, my look. I'm just a simple, poor vault dweller walking around, turning on turrets so that you could die. Just a normal thing to do. Okay, I warned you not to follow me. Where'd you go? Something smells fishy. Ba-dum-sh. Nah, that was a terrible joke. That was a very bad joke. That was a very, very bad joke. Whoa, I cut off the nasty. Fight me, crab. You're nothing like Mr. Krabs. You are a disgrace. I hope you die. I will fight you. Oh, there's two of them. Never mind. I'm out. Run. Are they gone? No, they're not. They're not gone. Ah, they're coming. And they're close by. And the stairs. Hey, another car. Why can't I activate the terminal? Oh, it's on fire, that's why. What the heck? How'd you get up here? How'd you guys get up here? You're working with vault. Oh, shoot. Uh-oh. Can't come upstairs. Oh, they can. Oh, that's bad. Wait.
Okay, I had enough. I'm using my capacity Gauss rifle. So you're dead. Listen, enemy has been mutated. Fight me then, crab. Okay, wait. Fight me now. Yoo-hoo! Crabby! Get out of here! Oh boy. Why can't we just be friends? Everything could have been so good. Thank you. Yeah, there we go. Okay, you know what? After this, I am going to end the video. Well, live stream. And that will be the end of the video and live stream. So sad for it to be ending, but it's already been an hour and close to 30 minutes long, and I shouldn't have this running on for a long way. I'm getting stuck. I may live stream next week. There will be a video on There will be a video on Thursday. I will live stream, I don't know what day, next week. I will do that. You can decide whether it should be Battlefield 4 or Battlefront, if Battlefront works. You can decide between those two, because those are the only two FPS games that I have. So, yeah. Trust me, you can see me when I'm playing an online game, or an FPS game, I should say. I'm crazy. When I'm crazy, it means I'm terrible at the game. I am so bad. Whoa, hello, Dad. Good morning to you, my love. Ooh, one hit to the face. That is deadly. Okay, there's one more turret. That one's on. Those two are on. That one's on. I guess that one's on. Where's the other one? Hey, wait a second. I've been activating the turrets. Look it. I activated this one, did I not? I did. Terminal. Enter password. I only entered the password. And that was it. Fight me. Right, stop. Hey, mac and cheese. Nuked out mac and cheese, I should say. Very nuked out. Set up here, and we have to reactivate it again.
Boy.
Enter password. Activate turret. Let's go. Can't wait to be done with this mission. This mission is tedious. I'm just glad that Mire Lurks and not Deathclaws, because if they were Deathclaws, I would be dead. So, even though I'm complaining that I hate Mire Lurks, which I really do, I'm just glad they're not Deathclaws. Because that would be bad. Oh yeah. Hey, hey, check this out, look it. From Doctor Who, Geronimo! Imagine I died. That would've been so messed up if I would've died. I just jumped down and done. Where is the stairs? Oh, there they are. Not really stairs, just more like wooden planks leading up to the place. Well, I could just run right there after I was done with that one. I didn't have to jump off. Well, that was dumb. I did it. Report back to Barney. Let's go. Oh, maybe we can finish this mission before a minute 30. Come on, let's go, let's go, let's go, little darling. Tell me how you're. I don't remember the lyrics to that song. Going to get my XP and possibly receive a reward for the bravery that I have done.
Hey, Barney.
You did it, didn't you? Ha! I could hear that sweet, sweet machine gun music all the way down here. You almost caught me in Reba's
What the? He followed us? I mean, like, I thought Cog would be able to take care of it, but this is disgusting. I mean, I saw it on the red dot. This is crazy. Kill it! Kill it! Kill it! Where's Reba when you need her? Kill it! Kill it! Kill it! Ooh. Smackdown. Kill it. And the uppercut punch from Rocky Balboa. Ooh, but he strikes back. But Rocky can. Oh, he got shot. Never mind.
Hey,
you did it, didn't you? Ha! I could hear that sweet, sweet machine gun music all the way down here. You almost caught me in Reba at once.
Is that it? Will they come back?
They might. They'll have something to think about if they do. Now,
he has a pimple on his nose.
About that reward. Here's a key to my workshop in the bunker. Reba 2 should be sitting on the table in there.
Oh,
I'd say you earned her. Now, if you'll excuse me, I believe today is earmarked for some target practice. The Salem Volunteer Militia never rests.
Hey, cool.
I think this is a common sight these days, huh? I'm sure some would even call this clean.
Besides the gigantic dead body of a Marler. Yeah, this is clean. I burped into the mic, and you just heard it all. Where's Reba 2? I want to find Reba 2. Yeah, toilet. Reba. Reba. There you are.
Ooh. Yes.
Oh, it's a sniper. Cool. Well, I'm going to be ending it right here. Oh, sweet. Even better. Okay. Well, that is it. Thank you all for tuning in. Shout out once again. This has like been the, 72nd time a shout out to Nick Swanson. He has been with us since the beginning of it. And I do hope that you all enjoy it. As I say, I look incredibly handsome right now. I look like a regular, genuine fashion model. Anyway, be sure to rate, comment, and subscribe. Make sure that you share this with your friends and family if they like to enjoy this kind of stuff. And I'll be seeing you guys. Hold up. Wait a second. Next time. And see ya.